today is to kind of give you a little overview. Possibly things that it could be very useful to you, because certainly it's been useful to me personally and to many of my patients. For one, a personal story here. When I was 6 years old, growing up in Taiwan, one summer, my mother was teaching, off teaching summer school. We were constructing after the fourth and fifth floor to our house. And so, you know, these bamboo scaffoldings on the outside of the building, some of you may be familiar with. So my brother and I climbed up to the rooftop of our three-story house, which, like I said, was under construction to be added, the two more floors. And we picked up two sips, and we were having a heck of a sword fight. And anyway, he's bigger than me, so I ran. He chased after me, then I ran after him. And he ran to the edge of the building, and he kind of went that way, and I went over. So I fell from the rooftop of a three-story house onto the asphalt pavement. And there I was, completely unconscious in a puddle of blood. So it was another 30 minutes before my father was able to sort of bring me into the house. He's also a doctor trained in medicine, and so he practiced on the first story of our house. And there I would remain on his treatment table for about a month. I was in a coma for a month. And so what I'm going to share with you, you know, today, as well as in my books, Secrets of Self-Healing and Secrets of Longevity, are things that I have experienced, you know. So this is very personal to me. And of course, after I recover from this long journey back to health, in the process, I think I've knocked a few marbles loose, because, you know, really good excuse. My wife accuses me of forgetting things. I said, well, remember I fell from three stories. Anyway, so, and she's not here, so that's a good thing. All right, a little background. So I was trained really at home because generations of medical practice, and but we had to go to college too, you know. So we, both my brother and I graduated from university both here and abroad, and I did my postgraduate residency in Shanghai. And subsequently got involved in a lot of anti-aging medicine specialty, so board certified anti-aging medicine from the American Board of Anti-Aging Medicine. 20 years ago, we founded a university in our grandfather's honor, Yosan University, located in Los Angeles. We also have a group practice in Santa Monica called Dallow Wellness. We have a number of specialties, infertility, as well as integrative cancer care and wellness medicine. I went on to co-found the acupuncture.com, which is one of the sort of largest websites on the internet on acupuncture and Chinese medicine. And healingpeople.com, which is a integrative medical website. And recently, in the last 2 years, I have teamed up with Yahoo. So I now have a blog on Yahoo Health, and it's been running for about 2 years now. It's fun getting information out to the public, and, you know, and Ask Dr. Mao is where a lot of my public outreach efforts have been. So really, my efforts besides patient care, which I do quite a bit, I've been in practice for almost 25 years now. I know I don't look it. That's a good thing. I don't intend to act like it either. So, all right, so my family, I can only trace back to two generations, really. You know, my father, who has been an inspiration to me and my mentor and teacher for many years. And he has devoted his whole life to helping the world. So he has written many books on the subject of Taoism, and constructive life, how to live a constructive lifestyle, as well as Eastern health and fitness, and so forth. And my grandfather, his father, Yosan, whom I've never met actually, because he passed away in the 60s, and I was born in the 60s, so, you know, it's we kind of crossed paths, but, you know, I remember, it's one of these things you remember because when you were falling from three stories and you look up and you saw the sky, you saw your feet, so you knew you were going head down first, and then, in an instant, my grandfather's face flashed in front of my eyes, and then I passed out. I felt no pain, so. And he had been, you know, he had deceased me about a year prior to my accident, so I think we have a strong connection there. Here are some of my books. I also have a book on Tai Chi. Now, I wanted, just before I go any further, just to thank Arnold Taiyam and his students at the Longevity Center for sponsoring this talk. So, thank you.